टुडे आई विल डू ए इंटरेस्टिंग केमिस्ट्री रिलेटेड एक्सपेरिमेंट इट इज जंपिंग ऑफ सोडियम जंपिंग ऑफ सोडियम फॉर दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी फॉलो सम स्टेप्स एट फर्स्ट टेक ए सिलिंड्रिक मेजरिंग सिलिंडर और यू कैन ऑल्सो टेक ए टेस्ट ट्यूब and take few amount of water, few ml of water. Next, add that is your phenolphthalein. Add your phenolphthalein solution. This is your phenolphthalein solution. Next, this is your kerosene. You can take gasoline also. This is your kerosene. Now add the kerosene. The kerosene will float over the water. And this is your sodium metal. This is your sodium metal. Here also kerosene is already present. It is said to be this is the water level, this is your kerosene level. Now take a piece of sodium metal which is present in the beer bottle. This is your watch glass. This is your knife. Before cutting the sodium, it is highly necessary that whether the knife is present in dry condition or not. Now cut the sodium by the help of knife. It is highly necessary or to make a precaution that the sodium do not come in contact with the water molecule. If it come in contact with water molecule, then an explosive reaction will be possible. So avoid from the moisture particles. This is the oxides of sodium. Pure sodium is your this brightness. This is your pure sodium, and these are the oxides. Because when sodium come in contact with the air, then it converted into its oxide. So our aim to take the pure sodium, not the oxide. Take the pure sodium. Pure sodium can easily cut, but oxides are very hard. So take the pure sodium molecule, sodium metal. This is the pure sodium. This is your pure sodium. Now put the sodium piece in the solution. Look at that, what will happen? Reaction takes place. Sodium element goes on reaction. Sodium metal undergoes reaction. Evaporation takes place. Some gas particles some gas as released. If you check well, the sodium metal jumps slowly. Look at the interesting colors. There are white water is present here, also phenolphthalein present, but there is sodium hydroxide is present. When sodium react with the water molecule, then it gives a
sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. The gases, the hydrogen gas released from this solution, and sodium hydroxide is a base, strong base. When it comes in contact with the phenolphthalein, then light pink color is obtained. That means from this experiment it is clear that up to this region sodium hydroxide is present. This is your kerosene. Why it is highly necessary to take the kerosene? Because if you direct put the sodium metal to the water, then what will happen? An explosive reaction will done. So when the sodium come in contact with the water molecule, then the reaction start, and as a result sodium hydroxide is produced. Up to this level sodium hydroxide is produced. Till now the water molecule do not come in contact with the sodium metal. Here sodium metal is present. In this, here sodium metal is present. Here, up to this, that is your kerosene. Up to this, your sodium hydroxide. This is your water level. If you shake well, then or stirring with the help of a glass rod, then complete reaction takes place. Already now all the water molecule react with the sodium metal, hydrogen gas releases upward of the measuring cylinder. Now this is your sodium hydroxide. It come in contact with the phenolphthalein, light pink color is obtained. That is your kerosene. This is a very good chemistry experiment. In this experiment, this is the main reaction takes place. That is all about this experiment. Now I will do another experiment, interesting experiment. For this experiment, we generally take lead nitrate. Next is your potassium iodide. This is your potassium iodide. And we take two beaker. At first, take 2 ml of potassium iodide. Your potassium iodide. Next is your lead nitrate. This is your said to be spatula. Already you know about this. This is your said to be lead nitrate. Take some lead nitrate. Make a solution of lead nitrate. Make a solution of lead nitrate. This is your lead nitrate solution. Actually, distilled water is taken for making the pure lead nitrate solution. This is the proper way for stirring to mix the solution. This is your said to be glass rod. This is your said to be your lead nitrate solution. Now take a conical glass, wash it clearly. That is your said to be conical glass. At first, it is highly necessary to wash the conical glass properly. At first, take the potassium iodide solution. Next, this is your lead nitrate solution. Take the lead nitrate solution. Look at that. Yellow precipitate is formed. Very interesting color. This is your yellow precipitate. Look at that. This is your very good yellow precipitate. Next, take the tripod stand. This is your Bunsen burner. This is your tripod stand. And this is your wire box, wire case. Now start burning. Now start firing. Open the gas line. Now put the conical cuts over the wire case and subject it the conical cut for heating. During heating, the precipitate complete the clear solution will be produced. After heating 10 to 15 minutes, stop the heating or aim to heat the solution for getting a clear solution to dissolve the precipitate. Now it is subjected for cooling. Just like this, it is subjected for cooling. After cooling half an hour, seen that there is a gold flag is produced. Look at that clearly. This is your gold flag. Interesting gold flag are produced. That is your considered as the golden rain experiment.